As he waits in the wings. There's the stats, there's the numbers, there's the countries. Both of them from Sweden, 30 and 26 years old. You can see European Rallycross champion, ninth in standings. Now, keep in mind, Kevin Eriksson missed the first two rounds. We saw him most recently in California. He had an injury, really bad injury to his leg, and he was kind of transparent about it. His dad was driving a car, hit him, damaged him, hurt him, and it was scary.
It was scary.
It's great to see Kevin back out here.
Chris Fix just will
pass. All right. Enough about me. It's about Larsson.
He's had a broken leg as well. We'll get him in to talk about that in a minute. That's
Larsson and Eriksson, let's send it here. Eriksson, Larsson, who's going to get the jump? And it looks like Robin Larsson, the number four, gets the dump, the jump, the DRR JC RX Cartel vehicle. Kevin Eriksson, the Olsbergs, Dixon, number 23. And Larsson, like I said, he look at Larsson diving. I mean, just taking that tighter line. Eriksson trying to go high to low.
Kevin's got to be closer than this, Jared. So the drivers will have been looking. They always look at the other races to go. How's the track developing for a start? You can hear Fraz already going, what's going on in terms of lap times? They'll be asking if there's any holes out there where the blue groove is. But so they're watching the whole time to try and figure it out. And he'll have seen where that pass from Meek was. He'll have seen where Martel managed to get into McConnell a minute ago. You're looking for those opportunities, but they are not there if you're not right on the boot lid, the trunk lid of the car in front. You've got to be right on the back. Now Kevin's tidied it up. He's got to pull back one more car length. Then he can start thinking about nibbling away and attacking.
Nibbling? You haven't lunch
nibbling.
Yet?
Nibbling. I had a lunch, yeah. I had a good lunch.
All right, so speaking of lunch, there is some dust for your diet, some fiber up in your face, and Larsson continues on. Kevin Eriksson needs to gain some ground, and there's that tighter line you're talking about, pulling the handbrake. But look at Kevin sliding out. Just does not have the proper setup for this track right now.
0.7 seconds in it. It's just that first lap, I think, where Kevin went in a little bit too hot into turn two. They're both very good drivers, and when the other guy is as good as you are, it's hard to close down any time. 0.8 at this point. Kevin super sideways in the background. Look at Larsson. Larsson's keeping it pretty tidy by comparison to some of the others through here. 0.8 it's saying. We'll find out again as they come over the start finish line if he's managed to close it down at all. They've got one lap to go. No Yokohama Joker tire lap, remember. Look at that. Yeah. Oh my God, that's the drone under the start finish.
Let's go.
Yes, I like it.
Nice shot there. And again, that blue groove just grows and grows.
That's insane. That is such a... I was like,
you like the drone
what
shot?
What camera is that? You know, but that's what I love about the drones is, traditional motorsport, we've been lucky enough to announce motorsport for a long time. And you've had your fixed cameras. You know, it's in turn two, it's in turn three. And there's something like, where is that? And it's a drone that someone's done something awesome with. And we're so lucky to have such great drone pilots bringing us that action. I love it.
Yeah, we've been utilizing them a lot in the Formula Drift Championship. And it's a great addition to Rallycross. We've been using them, almost 7-8 years now.
Yeah,
so
amazing.
It's been quite some time.
Gives you a different perspective, doesn't it?
Yeah,
a really
totally.
Different perspective.
Yeah, the drifting world, we utilize them for judging as well. So that's always great. But from a sensational standpoint, it's definitely a different perspective. As you can see, two of them actually out there on track, not just the vehicles, but making it look easy. Robin Larsson gets the win, knocking out Kevin Eriksson. So it'll be Larsson versus McConnell. And that of Ollie Eriksson versus Chris Meek.